Hey there guys, this is Josh once again with the PC-BSD YouTube channel. I've got a new tutorial for you guys today. We are going to be building the Lumina desktop environment on a FreeBSD or TrueOS based system. So for the purposes of this demonstration, I have TrueOS already set up in a virtual environment, and that's what I'm going to be showing you guys is TrueOS, but it's very, very close to FreeBSD. In fact, you can run all the same instructions pretty much, and you'll be able to accomplish the same thing. So let's get to it. I'm going to flip over here and I'm going to go ahead and log in. All right, there we go. We're logged in. Now, for those of you that may not be familiar, I'm just going to give you a brief update on what Lumina is. Lumina is a BSD licensed desktop environment. It's very new. It's in beta right now. It was created by Ken Moore. Ken works for the PC-BSD project with me and Chris and Drew. And he started this as kind of a side project. I don't know that Ken really knew how big this was going to get, but there's already been a tremendous amount of support and interest from the community, so we really appreciate that, guys, and we wanted to go ahead and get this video made for you. So you do have a couple of different options if you want to check it out on your FreeBSD or TrueOS system. So anyways, let's go ahead and get started here. There is going to be quite a bit of code in this, and so I'm going to go ahead and put that in the description after the video uploads. So if you do need to kind of review that without going back through the whole video, I will try to list the steps for you. All right, let's go over here. All right, so first things first, we have to install the packages. This part will take quite a while, so go ahead and just type pkg install lumina xorg and qt4-image formats. All right. Oh, yep. Of course. You do need to run this as root. So let's flip over there and do the same thing. Package install lumina xorg and qt4-image formats. There we go. Now it's off and running. Do we want to proceed with this action? Why, yes, we do. So we're going to go ahead and press yes and enter. Okay guys, we're off and running. Now the download is going to take a little bit, like I said before, so I'm going to go ahead and just do a quick cut on the video right now, and we'll jump back in several minutes later when it finishes, okay? I'll kind of give you an idea of how long it took, so. Okay guys, we're back again. It looks like our packages did finish, so that's good. It seems like my internet connection is running quite a bit faster than last night, so that's a good thing. Alright, so let's see where we're at. We just installed all of the packages. The next thing that we need to do is we need to set up X as root. So still from your root user account, we're going to go ahead and we're going to edit slash etsy slash rc.conf. You can use whatever editor you want. I prefer just to use edit. It's easy for me. Get around. Alright guys, and you're going to want to add these four lines to the rc.conf file. Hal-d enable equals yes. That's the first one. Dbus enable equals yes. Mouse d underscore enable equals equals yes. And the last one, mixer enable equals yes. That is required for some of the audio control in Lumina, so make sure you do add that one as well. All right, let me double check our lines here and make sure everything looks correct real quick. We have a hal-d enable. Yes. All right, we've got all our quotation marks. All right, I think we're good. So I'm gonna go ahead and press escape, leave editor, save changes. There we are. Okay. Now the next thing we need to do is we need to go ahead and restart the system. So we're going to go ahead and issue the shutdown command, shutdown-r now. Okay, great. Now just give it a minute here, guys, to restart and we should be back in business. Okay, looks like we're ready to log in now. Okay, we went ahead and logged back in as our user. Next thing you want to do is you want to create a file. The easiest way I've found to do this is I'm just going to type in edit, and we're going to do the tilde mark backslash dot x xinitrc, that is the name of our file, and then press enter. Okay, very good. And now once you're in this file, you want to just add a couple of lines of code. Pound symbol, exclamation mark, slash bin, slash sh, then slash user, slash local, whoops, local, there we go. Slash bin slash lumina dash de. All right, let me just inspect these real quick, make sure we got them right. Okay, this does look right. All right, let's go ahead and save by pressing escape, leave editor, save changes. All right, and of course the next thing we need to do is we need to go ahead and make that executable. So we're gonna do chmod 755, and we're going to do that on the file we just created. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Okay, so we have all the preliminary steps done. So if everything was done correctly now, it should just work once we type start x. And press enter. Okay, so far so good. There's our background. Let's go ahead and... Looks like this is hiding the toolbar up here, so let me get rid of this annoying little banner. Okay. And so you can see we are in Lumina now. So that's all it takes, guys. We're already in Lumina, and now we can kind of play around and look around at some of these features that we have here. System volume, screen brightness, that doesn't work in VirtualBox, so I can't show you that right now, but maybe we'll be able to get that in later. Workspace support, and of course your logout button so you can log out, reset the computer. And then this is going to be where you have all your applications. This is all the stuff that comes with Lumina. So you guys can check all that out if you want. Nice little file manager built in here that Ken wrote. As you guys can see, it does what it's supposed to do. One cool little thing you can do now is if you want to add an application, you can use an application launcher. And what you would do is you would basically just click on add the plugin, and then you'd select the application, whatever you wanted to be, basically to have an icon right here. So that's kind of neat. Helps you manage your icons and it doesn't get too messy. You know, you do have to do it manually right now, but that may be something that Ken decides to change later on. So, but yeah, anyways, we don't need to do that right now, so we'll just press cancel. One thing you guys will notice is there's nothing here. I mean, it's completely blank. You're not going to see any of the PC-BSD tools. If you want to basically make it into PC-BSD, then there's some extra steps you have to do. And we'll talk about that maybe in another video. But for now, this video was just on building Lumina, just to show you guys how easy it is to build it in FreeBSD and in TrueOS. So at any rate, guys, thanks for watching the video. We appreciate it so much, and you guys have a good day. Thanks, bye.